The Canadian stock market underperformed the U.S. stock market in 2017, and so far in 2018, it's been following suit. If we take a look at the S&P TSX 60 index representing Canada here, we can see here that, yes, there was positive performance in 2017, but it wasn't substantial. In fact, the Canadian market substantially underperformed the U.S. market, in this case, the S&P TSX 60 relative to the S&P 500. For 2017, you can see the downward sloping underperformance trend. Looks like a bit of a ski slope. And then you can see here in 2018, the underperformance as well. So a lot of investors believe that if Canada underperforms 1 year, and then it should outperform the next year. Not necessarily so. It all depends on what's happening with the major sectors in the marketplace. And if we take a look at the major sectors in the Canadian market, of course, there's more sectors, but these three tend to be some of the bigger drivers for the Canadian stock market. The Canadian energy sector, represented by the ETF XEG, gold miners, represented by the ETF XGD, and the Canadian banks, represented by the ETF ZEB. And if we take a look here and you say, wow, looks like strong performance for the Canadian banks, but all three of these sectors have underperformed the S&P 500, with the Canadian banks producing approximately 2.5% return since the end of December in 2017. And here with the S&P TSX 60 index, still from December 29th, still below around that 1% level. So all three of these sectors have underperformed the U.S. stock market. What we really need to see is at least two of these sectors outperform the U.S. stock market, and then we see a much better performance of the Canadian stock market relative to the U.S. stock market. The good news is that the Canadian energy sector, well, so far has not been performing well. In fact, the Western Select oil prices are about $24 less than West Texas crude, which is a fairly substantial difference in hurting the Canadian energy companies. But even in the States, the U.S. energy companies have been underperforming the S&P 500. But the good news is that the seasonal period for the Canadian energy sector is coming up, February 25th, and so we might see a bit of an uptick even before that, which would help the overall markets. Gold miners, we tend to see gold bullion and silver bullion do well, at least at the beginning of the year. That might fade a little bit, but Canadian banks are also coming up in their seasonal period as well. So if we start to see some stronger performance from at least a couple of these sectors in the marketplace, you know, we might see an uptick for the overall Canadian stock market. So far, that hasn't happened, as all three of these major sectors have underperformed the U.S. stock market. But if we look, you know, from a seasonal perspective, overall, seasonally, the Canadian stock market slightly favored from this time until at least until April. Not a substantial outperformance from a seasonal period, but it's slightly favor the Canadian stock market. And so